Cramer. I'm going to show you three pictures of the emotions before I do my speech.
Sort of like a emoji kind of thing. Jacob's an artist.
When you're happy, you resolve problems with the bully. And if it gets out of hand, it can turn into whatever you're the bully is sad. And sometimes that will happen with the bully or just using what they're saying. And then your reaction is really mad at you. Just because of what they said.
He likes emojis. He's an artist.
I just find it kind of funny though to do like emojis.
No, I think it looks nice. We were talking about this too, different ways to react to bullies. And Jacob said a lot of times what I like to do is if somebody says something, make a joke about it. And we'll just talk to you for fun. There used to be an expression, I'm rubber, you're glue, whatever you say bounces off of me and goes on to you. So we were saying that we laugh things off. You can't let everything affect you because everybody's different. And if you have very obvious differences, then that's when kids want to say something to bring attention to it, to take attention off of themselves. So if you laugh and talk or make light of it, that's one way of handling things where it doesn't make you feel bad about yourself or get mad. You could laugh it off if they say, well, why can't you pick this up? What's wrong with you? What's wrong with your hands? Why can't you pick that up? That's easy. Anybody can do that. Say, I don't know. I'm like a fish. I have fins or something. You know, like, say something that shows that you're not affecting you. Because that's what they want to do. They want to hurt you, and that's what a bully does. They want to push your buttons.
together at the park. Having fun and doing welcome when the ball came. The shark showed his teeth and he growled as he swam, moved a side mark.
Fishes.
It's my turn to scream.
It's my turn to scram.
Okay.
So who's being a bully?
The shark.
The shark is being a bully. Who's he bullying?
All the little fish.
All the little fish. Look at that.
Friends all around him swam to
the friends all around him seemed to shrink back to
Mr. Fish's
great
laugh. Oh, I don't know what to do. Shark attacked badly. The name is wrong. I'm just one fish.
Am I
really that strong?
So he fell because he was so afraid. He said he's only one little fish. What could he do? So he fell on the floor and didn't know what to do. He was scared. He said, "Look,
the water flowed calm and the friends found their way. Back to laughter filled fully in a sheer day.
What do you think they're happy now?
Shark's gone. But the shark came around again and he used a bad name. He shouted, "Get lost. I'm the boss of the kingdom." Mr. Fish
shrank
back with his feeling in a clump. Fear blew inside him in a weird, heavy clump.
So his stomach was feeling tumble. because what did the shark say?
You're the fin.
You're the fin.
Yeah, I'm not allowed to that part, to be honest. But it's all around them, seem to think back to Mr. Fish's face.
Fizzled.
Oh, I don't know what to do. Shark attacked badly, being mean and wrong. But I'm just one fish, and I really was that strong.
So even though they know the shark is acting badly, they all know that the shark is a bully. The one fish keeps saying, I'm just a little fish. Am I that strong? What am I supposed to do?
He tried to leave the park, feeling sad, but thought went through. Then slowly came a thought. There was something that he could do. Words can make a difference when things go wrong. Yes, I'm just one fish, but my voice is strong.
My voice is strong. That's true, isn't it? Everybody can say something, right? It doesn't take much to say something.
Mr. Fish turned back and directly chased the shark. It was time to talk straight about what happened in the park. Mr. Shark, said Mr. Fish, you have broken up our fun. Well, he isn't who you are, but it is what you have done.
Telling him that that's not who he is. He ruined our fun, and that's not who you are. Tell him he should be nice.
The things you did were mean, and that's not what you expect. So please leave until you're ready. Us with respect. As Mr. Fish spoke up and his words rang out loud, the friends all around him formed an upstanding crowd.
Wow, because he's one voice, because he said something. Could you believe everybody else felt the same way? And now they gathered behind him so that one voice became a strong, loud voice. If he didn't stand up and say anything, nobody else would have said anything either. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing?
Yep. Together they were stronger. Now none of them were scared. They cared about each other and the ocean of world they shared. Soon Mr. Fish was laughing and his friends were having fun. Turns in using empathy each and every one.
So that means that now they know how they feel. Huh?
The park filled again with the joyful sounds of play, plus the confident of knowing who to keep it that way, how to keep it that way. We are kind, we are fair, we are all Christian friends, so we speak up when we need to.